Welcome to What the Flick, everybody. The Americans winding down. Two more episodes to go. This is season 6, episode 8, The Summit. Alonzo, Meredith, Brooke, Ben. Big crew here for this. Oh, man, this show is good.
This episode.
So this, I think in terms of the great seasons of this new age of television, you know, like all the Sopranos seasons and The Wire and stuff. But recently, like the season 1 of Homeland, season 1 of The Americans, and now this final season of The Americans.
Oh, no question.
Just sensational.
The thing that sort of struck me is we know that Philip and Elizabeth aren't where they started. The Cold War isn't where it started.
Right.
By dint of the fact that they don't kill Jackson and Stavros.
That's right.
Like both of them, I thought, oh, you're dead now. Right. And then they're not. And I was like, okay, so clearly we've progressed.
Tougher call for Elizabeth.
Yes. But things are changing.
She had no problem sleeping with the young college intern, but killing him, that crosses the line for her. But that was a pivotal moment where I thought we had lost. I mean, I feel like we've had this conversation where I thought that was the black mark in Elizabeth's soul was gone for good if she killed that kid. Mm-hmm. And then she said no. And then the fact that she goes on to not just say, I'm not going to kill Stavros. And I'm like, oh.
Or not, she's
no,
not.
No, Philip doesn't kill Stavros.
She doesn't kill the
Jackson.
Yeah, right, Jackson, sorry.
No, and then she doesn't kill Nestrichenko
Nestrichenko.
She was more upset by Philip questioning her humanity than the betrayal and the lies.
But she obviously at some point, if she's mad at Philip and she's sort of pretending that it's a betrayal, even though she also has obviously done some betraying on her part. But she's come around. I mean, recognized she's such a good agent, so smart that she recognized, wait a minute, I'm not sure I'm working for the people who I thought I was working for.
I mean, that was a wake-up call. That was the proverbial come-to-Jesus moment when Philip called her on her actions, and she's like, wait, what am I doing?
I thought we were headed for some violent confrontation, perhaps between them, perhaps over Paige. Mm-hmm. Still may be coming, but her behavior here in the last 20 minutes of this episode would indicate that we may have a Philip Elizabeth coming together.
Oh, clearly. I think because after talking to Claudia, she realizes, okay, this is actually a thing.
Like he's right.
You know, that scene.
I know, that scene, again, this is a testament to Margot Martindale, but we see Claudia, who I didn't trust her at first. I didn't like her. Yeah, I came to at least understand, and I felt that she was like, you know, just part of the system as well. But then realizing she's been in on it the whole entire time, and that's there's a switch when the camera's up on close on her, and you see like, oh no, she is anti like Gorbachev party, hook, line, and sinker, and the whole idea of protecting Elizabeth is no, she's controlling, she's managing, she's running.
And then also as we think back to that horrible murder of the courier, and then his wife who surprised Elizabeth, and then the kid was
Mr.
there.
Mr. and Mrs. Teacup.
You know, I've always thought, you know, we've talked about this on our other reviews, our other conversations, is that there was no reason. That guy was in the witness protection program. His spying was over. Mm-hmm. The murder of him was punitive.
Yeah.
And like sending a message. So, and now that came from Margot Martindale, which means it came from what has become like this dark splinter group in the center. Maybe it is still the center, but the Politburo and the party are now a different path.
But we're all in the party.
That's right. But that. So that murder, that horrible murder, the one that shook Philip, right, was sort of conducted not, you know, that's not Gorbachev, and that group probably would have thought, yeah, I don't care, that guy's gone now. Like, his damage is done. Have at it. This is not what we're about anymore. So that was totally unnecessary.
Yeah, that was a bit of old school Soviet that they were still hanging on to.
I was going to say, sometimes they kill people for good. This happened in this episode, too.
Who got killed for good? The artist.
But she snapped back out of it really quick. Like, come up here, spend time with your dead wife. And then pictures.
She's always got her eye on the ball.
Nothing makes me more tense, not in television, in the world, than someone in a place where they're not supposed to be snooping around. I mean, literally. I mean, Jim Rockford looking through files, and I'm always like, oh, somebody's going to come in.
For me, it's people in cars. Because this is the era now of, like, the sudden T-boning.
Oh, right.
You know, or, like, somebody walking the street and just getting run over. Like, that's what sets me on edge.
I was like, oh, he's going to come downstairs. He's going to come in. Stop. Get it done. Switch shoes. Come on.
Why is she moving it? Oh, why should you take all that time to move it from the box all the way over the table? What are you doing?
And the way it was shot, though, you know, in fact, this whole season, reason. It's been shot in frames that we expect someone to walk in and on the room, well, and walk in and see them.
We were just talking about that outside. So that was the one of the great things that they do is that as she grabs the college boy's arm and you think, oh, he's dead.
Yeah.
And then I love that they're like basically on a busy street, and then, oh, fortunately there's an alley with a dumpster and an underpass.
Yeah. Right? DC is lousy. Yeah.
I kept thinking like, oh, there's gonna be so much blood. Oh, what?
And then they gave us that shot. They went inside the car, and then we go outside the car where we get that shot where you see her baby pull the gun, and you see his head go back into the blood splatters on the window. They gave us the shot before the murder. Mm-hmm. And then we went back, and she takes her hand off.
She'll be going to the pavement business.
Yeah. And then she asked the thing that she has asked
Do
before.
You understand?
Tell me you understand. And he goes, I don't. Mm-hmm. And you're like, dude, kid, what's wrong with you? And then she still let him go.
Well, because I think she realized at that moment, this is a kid. This is just a kid. Like,
I think she realized that Philip's right. I think, she'll kill a kid.
She'll kill a kid.
Even this is even pre-Claudia conversation. She's like,
we're not.
Yeah.
As he said, it's us. Like they tell us to do it, but in the end, this is us.
Meanwhile, sorry.
Especially knowing everything that she knows about what she's been through, she'll let her own daughter go into this. She'll kill a kid.
Well, and mind you, this was let's not forget, this was the kid that Paige was gonna date to get closer to his stuff, and she bangs him instead, which is like a little extra layer of creepy.
There's going to be consequences to that.
That's my favorite Elizabeth, though. I'm sure it's,
Carol. The blonde wig.
She did have pretty hair there.
She looked great. Oh, and I love how they also, we got to go, but that sort of the descriptor of her, you know, we sort of, when our early reviews, we would make fun of the fact that everybody looks period, except Carrie Russell.
Out of a wig,
They're still like, hey, we have Carrie Russell. She's still going to look like Carrie Russell. Except they acknowledged it a little bit, like Roy Rogers spent so much time with Roy Rogers in D.C., said, hey, you're a... you know, she had Vidal Sassoon hair.
That character was a deep cut. Like, you had to find him online. Yeah. Like,
Brooke and I were talking about that.
And how powerful just the storyline of Gregory was.
Yeah.
I was like, wait, where do I know him? Gregory! Then it took me back to, there were so many different pieces of that. So many people die in this TV show. Oh,
this is going to be a great rewatch.
And Gregory and Elizabeth were in love.
Yes.
It caused a rift between her and Philip for a little bit.
Oh, yeah.
Man, all right.
Two to go.
Some iteration of this panel will be back. We'll be back next week to talk episode 9, where we get, as we saw from the coming attraction,
Pastor Tim.
Yes.
Pastor Tim, baby. See ya.